Hi, here's the USB charger, and this charger actually connects with the cell phones with the USB jack like this one. Well, as you can see here, it's all connected with the very simple passive components that you are familiar with. And these components are like the capacitors, also the LED, the resistors, the voltage regulators, the diodes, and also the transformer here. Now, how this works actually, I'm going to plug it in and see. Give me a second, right? You see, it's connected, now it's charging. Well, after we have the 220 volts from the output, from the input, or they call it the wall socket or something like that. Well, and then it comes in here as an input voltage of 220 AC volts. And it's transformed by this transformer into 9 volts. Now, you have to keep in mind that the input here is AC and the output from this transformer is also AC. After that, we convert it into a DC through this bridge rectifier. It consists of 4 diodes. I'm going to explain that afterwards. Well, after this point, at exactly this particular point, we have the a DC and it's 9 too. Well, after that, it comes in here to the voltage regulator, and this voltage regulator is the LM7805. It converts it from 9 to 5 volts, and it's all in DC. And after we do that, we have the output from here. We connect it through a USB cable, and this USB cable has a 4 wires, and 2 for the power. These are the 2 that we need here, and the other 2 are used for the data transfer, like TX and RX, transmitter and receiver. We don't need that here. Well, I'm going to explain after that. I'm going to explain the exact details of these components and how each subcircuit works. Now, the input voltage is about 220 volts. It actually differs in some countries, like in the East, they have something around 240, not 220. For our frequency here in my country, we have 50 hertz. In the East Asia, they have around 60, I think. Well, since it's a sine wave, we have a change in polarity once in every cycle. Let's say take it from 0 to time t, we'll have one complete cycle, and in this cycle we have a change in polarity. Like in the first part of this cycle, we'll have the first lead as positive and the second lead is negative. And after that, like from time of t over 2, like the exact half of this cycle to the end of the time of this cycle, like from t over 2 to t, the different thing will happen. Like the first one, instead of being positive, it will be negative, and the second one will do the same. So from being negative, it will change to be positive, and that's how the sine wave works. And the bridge rectifier actually takes a very good advantage of this thing, or this phenomena of the sine wave, and I'm going to explain that just next. Quite briefly, the AC, or the bridge rectifier, works and takes advantage of the AC sine wave. And that's because when we have sine wave, as I said before, we'll have a change in polarity in these end wires, like or the 2 contacts of the input. So let's say here we have 9 volts AC, and in the output of this bridge rectifier, we'll have 9 volts DC. Okay? And that's because in the first cycle here, we'll have the first one as positive, the second one as negative. And when it happens, we'll have the positive lead here, where the current comes in here. And it can't go, once it reaches this place, it can't go in this direction because of the connection of this diode. So it will have to go through this diode to the positive lead. And in the other cycle, in other part of the cycle, the opposite thing will happen. This will be minus and this will be positive. So it will come in here and then go through this diode to the same positive contact of the output. So this part will always be positive, while the other part will always be negative. That's how we get the DC on the output. For the voltage regulator, we have the 7805 LM, and this actually converts from whatever, like, they actually have a maximum input voltage, something around 24 volts. It's DC, right? And it converts it to a lower value, such as for this particular one, we'll have 5 volts DC. Okay. Here's the first one, is the input voltage. This actually comes from the in our circuit, comes from the bridge rectifier. It's about 9 volts DC, and this is the grounding. And here we have the positive one. Also, you have to know the USB cables. Okay. They have 4 connections. Okay. Something up. 2 of them are the positive and negative, where you can feed them with 5 volts DC. The other 2, the RX and TX, we don't need them, so we'll ground them. Okay.